obviously youth is the future. Without youth, we will die out. This is a very basic statement. Empowering the youth in the European context means raising awareness about the issues that are important for young people and giving them the possibility to participate in, for example, the democratic processes. But of course, also giving them opportunities to take on jobs, to have a good education and things like that. So what we must learn, I think more, all of us, is to listen to youth first and to see what their concerns are. And in order to be able to voice their concern, they have to be empowered. So teach young people to make statements, to come forward with what they think is relevant in a professional way, if you want, and then have them actively participate in the processes that make society. Not dictate only from the older generation to the younger generation, but have also a mutual dialogue between the two in order to give youth instruments of participation. This is what I would call empowerment. Well, the arts traditionally help people grow beyond themselves. They help people come out of their comfort zone and learn new things. Arts help broaden horizons. And this is a very essential element for empowerment, that you are not limited only to your little nucleus life that you may know with your friends and family, but that you go beyond. Of course, I'm talking about the European aspect of it, that you learn languages and that you learn other cultures and traditions. And this actually constitutes a competency for you and eventually even, you know, may help you find a job. So I think it can be very, very practical. And the creative sector can contribute to this a lot because it opens minds, it opens hearts, it helps us understand each other better and to see the other person in another light. And that, of course, is always, I think, fruitful. Well, I think meeting vis-a-vis, face-to-face, is always important. Networking, specifically, we fund in Creative Europe, we fund networking among peers, peer-to-peer learning. In Europe, we don't have to reinvent the wheel all the time. There are experiences and there is knowledge out there, and we just have to get the right people together to connect them, to exchange this. It's actually a very efficient tool of raising a level of knowledge. In general, Europe works with this. Europe works with its people, meeting and knowing each other, speaking each other's languages. I'm also a strong proponent of language learning beyond the usual English. And this is why I think gathering and meeting, it doesn't always have to be face-to-face physically. Today it can also be, you know, a typical Skyping or a social media meeting. It doesn't have to be just standing together somewhere. It can be virtual. But this is, of course, also something that young people are very good at. You see, they don't have rooted traditional prejudices, and they can still use their openness and their exploring wishes to learn from each other, and eventually it creates a good moment for each person's personality. I'm very convinced of that, that we learn from the other. We never come out of an encounter as we came in from the encounter. You always hear other things. And this, beyond borders, works even more. I said that in my presentation. I think we all remain who we are, rooted in our local community, in our regional context, in our national context. But on top of that, I think indeed there's something like a European identity, but it doesn't substitute itself to the others. I would never ever say we should have only a European identity. I'm actually a bit careful about this concept, because it can only be something more. It can be defined by the values that we have, by the things that we believe in, that for me are good things, for example, as tolerance or, you know, certain other values that we have, democracy, equal rights and things like that. That can create a part of an identity if we follow this together. There we will be Europeans. But it doesn't exclude the others. We shouldn't be exclusive either. And young people have that even more because they're much more open and much more global than just European.